Give him thanks for your new dawn year. I thank you for my new dawn year is finally here. I give you glory and praise. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have given thanks. Whatever name Adam called every of the creatures, that was the name by which they were called. It is what you call that answers. Can I hear you say, 2018, my new dawn. Say it convincingly one more time. Your new dawn era has finally come. Our church began to be known as World Outreach Center when it was not reaching a corner. Living Faith World Outreach Center, E5 Ramat Close, and Gwarime Kaduna. World Outreach. Everybody had the opportunity to laugh us to scorn. World Outreach. Can't they advise them? World, we were reaching the wall when we were not reaching the street. What you call it today is what it answers you tomorrow. Your new dawn era has finally come. Every month of this year will deliver new dawn proofs in your life. Every week of this year we deliver new dawn proofs in your life. And because he daily loaded us with benefits, every day beginning from today we deliver new dawn proofs. Somebody believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Let me hear your loudest amen. Give the Lord a big hand of praise and please be seated. Heralding the new dawn era of the church. And we mentioned there, it's not just our local church platform, it's the church of Jesus on the earth. A new dawn came on the church in Egypt. Through the mystery of the blood of sprinkling. Their 430 years of captivity ended like a dream of the night. Through the mystery of the blood of sprinkling this early morning, the first day of January 2018, every siege of the wicked on your life shall be finally over. I will bring one more plague, or I will unleash one more mystery upon Pharaoh and upon Egypt. And afterwards, he will let you go. Exodus 11:1. when we let you go, he will surely trust you out hence altogether. You'll be turned to a hot coal of fire. He said, go, 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 go. And they did. By the mystery of the blood of sprinkling this morning, whatever is contrary to your new dawn heritage shall be broken off your life. And so, they were told to sprinkle the blood upon the two sides, the lintel and the two sides of the post of their doors. And when he sees the blood, he will not allow the destroyer to get into them. By the mystery of the blood of sprinkling today, you will not suffer any more assault from the wicked one. Somebody said about, you see, they told them to sprinkle the lintel and the two doorposts. Why are we sprinkling people? Well, you are God's building.
Yes, sir.
Praise God. So this is your lintel and this is your roof. 1 Corinthians 3:9. And ye are the temples of the Holy Ghost. 1 Corinthians 6:19. So you are a spiritual building. And so you are sprinklable.
Yes.
But that was then. How does it apply to us now? Exodus 12:24-25. The Bible says that ye shall observe this thing for an ordinance to thee and to thy sons forever. So the mystery of the blood of sprinkling is a forever ordinance. Verse 25. And it shall come to pass, when ye be come to the land which the Lord will give thee, according as he has promised, that he shall keep thee Sabbath. So it applies to every Jew, every seed of Abraham. And Romans 2:28-29, every child of God is a spiritual Jew. Galatians 3:29, if you be Christ, then you are Abraham's seed, and he has according to the promise. So it's a forever ordinance for all the seed of Abraham. Something's breaking loose in somebody's life. Now, by the mystery of the blood of sprinkling tonight, God is turning your morning to dancing forever. A mystery is simply a divine secret embedded in scriptures. That's a divine secret. More often than not, mysteries are validated by testimonies. They can't be explained. They can't be explained. They are validated. He said, if I do not, it was of my father, believe me not. But if I do, don't you believe not me, but believe for the very work's sake. Believe the work. The blood of Jesus is the blood of the everlasting covenant. Hebrews 13:20. Everlasting, effectual forever. That's the meaning. Effectual forever. Jesus is that lamb without blemish. So we partake of his blood in the communion by drinking it. We partake of the efficacy of that blood by sprinkling it as the Passover lamb. 1 Corinthians 5:7. For even Christ our Passover lamb be sacrificed for us. Now, the Passover blood is not for drinking, it's for sprinkling. It's for sprinkling. It's not for drinking, it is for sprinkling. They were commanded to sprinkle the blood, not to drink it. Jesus in administering communion said, "This is my blood." Now, in 1 Corinthians 5:9, is our Passover lamb that is sacrificed for us, not was. So the blood remains relevant today. As this blood is sprinkling, expect an end to the siege of all generational causes. I don't know why God did it, but he placed that cause that they shall be in a strange land and will be afflicted for 400 years. And after that, we'll bring them forth with much substance. Genesis 15:14. But 400 years went, they won't let them go. The gods of Egypt held them bound. God had to come down to bring them out. And he brought them out by the mystery of the blood of sprinkling. Now, wait a minute. In the name of the Lord Jesus, everything I may have been holding anybody down that won't let him or her go, you are going free this morning. That marital spell is finally broken. That hereditary disease is finally swallowed up. That career failure is finally broken. In the name of Jesus. That is unraveling the mystery of the Passover blood as it relates to you and me. Let's understand this morning that there is no idle statement in scriptures. Every scriptural statement is equally inspired, carries life in it. As this blood is sprinkled today, this hour, the first day of 2018, you shall not see any evil all through the year. We saw God commanding Moses to sprinkle both the book and all the people. Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 19 to 21. For when Moses had spoken every precept to all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop and sprinkled both the book and all the people. And all the people. Paul said, "I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus. It is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes." They entered their new dawn era by the blood. You are entering your new dawn era now. It was a most colorful entrance. All the hosts of Israel went up out of Egypt. All. Not one was left behind. And it came to pass after 430 years, the selfsame day, that all the host of the Lord went out from the land of Egypt. How many of them? Come and say, "I'm getting out." Say with me, I'm getting out. I am getting out this morning. I'm getting out of Egypt today. I'm getting out of the Egypt of shame and reproach. I'm getting out of Egypt of slavery and servitude. I'm getting out of generational curses today. Because all the host of the Lord went out of Egypt in one day. Therefore, this early morning, no one under the sound of my voice anywhere around the world shall be left behind. You believe it? Let me hear your loudest amen. Let me hear your loudest amen. And after the blood was sprinkled, in chapter 12 and verse 12, God said he was going to execute judgment upon all the gods of Egypt. All demonic strongholds holding any man's destiny bound, I decree execution of instant judgment. One of the characteristics of this new dawn era is vengeance. What do I call it? He said, Isaiah 63 verse 4, the day of vengeance is in my heart, because the year of my redeemed is come. Amen. Come and say, my year has come. Vengeance shall answer in the camp of your enemy this morning. God is executing vengeance in the camp of your enemy this morning. Because more often than not, until vengeance comes down, the wicked never gives up. When judgment against evil is delayed, therefore the heart of men is set, fully set in them to do evil, to do evil. When sentence against evil work is not executed speedily. So this morning, expect speedy execution of judgment against wicked work. You will hear news. You will hear news. You will hear news. Anyone that won't let you go must go for you today. Anywhere that won't let your family go must go for you today. What are you to expect? Expect your instant rescue from all satanic captivities. How many will say amen to that? Exodus 12 verse 33. After the blood of sprinkling was administered, the Egyptians were urgent upon the people that they might send them out of the land of Egypt. For they say, we be all dead men. Go, 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 go. Somebody else is going by force now. If you are that one, let me hear your loudest amen. Expect your instant rescue from all satanic captivities. What am I to expect, or you to expect? Expect instant release from all generational curses, spells, and enchantments. Come and say, I expect instant release from all generational causes, spells and enchantment. I expect instant release. In that Genesis 15, 13 and 14, we saw the 400 years of curse placed on them. And he said to Abraham, know of a surety that your seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years. And also that nation whom they shall serve will I judge, and afterwards they shall come out with great substance. 400 years, too long. Too long. Every generation of course ravaging anybody's life in one way or another. The snare is broken this morning. And you have finally escaped today. You believe it? Let me hear your loudest amen. Expect instant restoration of your health and vitality. As soon as they came out, there was not one feeble person among their tribes. Psalm 105 and verse 37. He brought them forth also with silver and gold, and there was not one feeble, not even sick, one weak. There was not one weakly person among their tribes. Ecclesiastes chapter 8 and verse 4. The Bible talks about their raiment waxed not old upon them, neither did their foot swell these 40 years. Expect by the mystery of the blood of sprinkling instant restoration of your health and vitality. The next 40 years, if Jesus tarries, you'll never know the meaning of sickness and disease. You believe it? Let me hear your loudest amen. Let me hear your loudest amen. That is what God has packaged for you and I through this mystery tonight. Number four, expect instant judgment against all the adversities of your destiny. Come on, say instant judgment. Say it loud, instant judgment. And against all the gods of Egypt will I execute judgment. I am the Lord. I decree instant judgment against all adversaries of your destiny today. You believe me? Let me hear your loudest amen. Well, expect access to a world of supernatural prosperity. Your servitude is over. Your slavery is over. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever is resisting your covenant practice, I decree your victory by the blood today. Whatever means blindfolding you against what is required of you to come into your wealthy place in Christ, I command it destroyed today. He gave them favor and they enjoyed massive wealth transfer. Watch it. There shall be testimonies after testimonies of supernatural wealth transfer. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Finally, expect double restoration of all that you may have lost to the devil hitherto. Expect what? Double restoration. Zechariah chapter 9, verse 11 and 12. The Bible says, as for thee also, by the blood of thy covenant, I have sent for thy prisoners out of the pit wherein there is no water. Turn ye to your stronghold, ye prisoners of hope. Even today do I declare that I will render double unto thee. If you start from verse 9, it's talking about the blood, talking about Jesus, the rider of the earth, and it talks about the blood of the covenant, engaging with the blood as prescribed in scriptures, among which is the blood of sprinkling. So expect double restoration of all that you may have lost to the devil hitherto. Double restoration of your health. Double restoration of your career. Double restoration of your business. Double restoration of your spiritual life. Expect a double restoration of all you may have lost to the devil hitherto, in the name of Jesus. Say with me, Christ is my Passover blood. And I believe in the mystery of the Passover blood. I believe in the mystery of the blood of sprinkling. And as I'm sprinkled this alimony, every of my expectation, as outlined this night, shall be released to me. Stand to your feet, everybody. Give the Lord a big, big hand of praise. Come on, give the Lord a big, big hand of praise. And as they were eating, Jesus took off the cup, and after giving thanks, he served it and said, "This is my blood." It's not anything special. It's any drinkable drink that you eat, drink on the table where you eat. He said, "This is my blood." Amen. It's the blood for remission of sins. It's also the blood of sprinkling. It's the same blood. Nobody has two kinds of blood. Every person carries the same kind of blood. So as this blood is sprinkled today, instantly, now you see, be serious minded. Be focused. Be intense. Don't be casual. Don't carry the thing and say, "Has he touched me? I don't know. Can I just touch me on it?" You know, I'm wearing my new year dress. They are going to put blood on it. Oh God. You know, Jesus tested me one day and I passed the test by his grace. He said, "Now, hand it over to me, Covenant University." And I said, "How, Jesus?" I said, "Lay down here before me." And I had a brand new shirt. Jesus, he didn't even ask me whether I'm willing to let this shirt go down. I did.
Amen.
The last heat forever.
Whatever.
The last heat forever.
Amen.
As this blood touches you today, everything it did in Egypt will be reenacted in your life. Amen. I went out one day and ministering to people at one of the street corners. And one man was saying, "Amen, amen, amen." In 3 days, everything turned for him. Don't say amen casually. Amen. Amen. The man was saying, "Amen, amen, amen." From joblessness, he became an employer of labor in 3 days. In 3 days. In 3 days. Don't be casual about anything. I said to you now that every generational curse hanging on any man's life, every enchantment, every divination, molesting and tormenting any destiny, at the instance of the blood, you are walking free. You are walking into your liberty. It's happening right now. It's taking place right now. By the mercy of this blood, you are stepping into your new dawn era. You are stepping into your new dawn era. Some runaway wife will return today. Some runaway husband will return today. Some job you have lost, you receive a message, come and take it. Your runaway children will return today. that life shall be restored to glory and honor today. Today marks the end of begging in your life. Your generation will never be beggars. They never saw money for 430 years, but money became their luggage.
Yes.
They were carrying gold and silver.
Hallelujah.
People never had any saving. Everything turned. Man, they were eating for free without planting or tendering. They were eating for free twice a day, flesh in the evening and manna in the morning. And for 40 years, Exodus 16:35, you must struggle for what to eat again. You must struggle for what to eat again. No wild beast assaulted any of them. No robbers will lay them for 40 years. The next 40 years of your life, no force of hell shall molest you anymore. Let me hear your loudest amen. Shout your loudest amen. Shout your loudest amen. Shout your loudest amen. Let all the ministers across our various churches around the world move towards the blood of sprinkling locations right now as I minister prophetically and we embark on the blood of sprinkling. Let all ministers now move to their respective locations as we administer this mystery. Amen. He said, beware lest by any means as Satan beget Eve through his subtlety, so your mind should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in the gospel. As the blood is sprinkled, death shall be swallowed up in victory. One elderly woman in Maiduguri many, many years ago came into this blood of sprinkling service. As the blood was sprinkled, the withered hand that had no blood flowing, blood began to flow. So expect instant intervention through the mystery of the blood of sprinkling tonight. Welcome to your new dawn era. Everything is speaking in your favor today. Every strange growth in your body will disappear instantly. Every blind eye shall be opened this hour. Every deaf ear shall be unstopped this moment. I decree that today marks a new dawn indeed in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every strange movement in your body will be silenced forever. Every poison you may have taken at any point, knowingly or unknowingly, shall be dissolved this hour. Every attack of the wicked you have been struggling with, they overcame him by the blood. By the blood. Now I decree your supernatural victory right now. Everything that won't let you go, as the blood is sprinkled, they will go down for you. Pharaoh pursued them after they departed, himself and the whole army of Egypt, and they were drowned in the Red Sea. Whatever refuses your going goes down for you today. Goes down for you today. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you. All over the world right now, ministers, you are all around the table of the Lord. The content of every vessel is declared the Passover blood of the Lamb. And as the blood is sprinkled, the destroyer shall never come into your dwelling. As the blood is sprinkled, the gods of the land that is all out against your destiny, judgment is executed against them. As this blood is sprinkled, your health and vitality is supernaturally restored. As this blood is sprinkled, all that you have been robbed of by the enemy is restored minimum double. Thank you, Father. Now, receive your instant healing. Receive your instant deliverance. Be set free in the name of Jesus. Be made whole in the name of Jesus. And may this mystery launch you into to your new dawn era 2018. In Jesus' precious name. Thank you, Father. It is done. Please pick up. Pick up from all over the places and get seated until you are sprinkled. Please don't stand up. While the choir continues to minister, you remain seated until you are sprinkled to make it easier for us to administer this mystery. Thank you, Jesus. All over the world in our various churches, now let's go ahead. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name. Now, receive it by faith. Be serious-minded about it. Receive it by faith.